Good evening, everyone. I'm Valerine Carvajal Campo. I'm a sommelier of Viña Las Pitras, and I also work as a tourist guide in the vineyard. Why Chile, said the presentation. Did you ask it yourself before? Why Marcos Rivera invited you to a conference in the south of Chile? I think he wanted to show you something important about our country. We are making wine, we are producing wine, and now we are an important country around the world in this area. Since 2017, we became in the fourth place of the exportation of wine in the world. We superate Australia. We have the same kind of wine that Australia produces, so it's a kind of proud for us to occupy this place. We are producing wine for the north of Chile, in the four region, to the south, in the United region. So we have two important regions in the central valley of Chile, which provide more or less 46% in the Maule region, where my vineyards are located, and then in the O'Higgins region, they provide 22% of the grape for wine in Chile. That's a lot of wine to drink, so we like that. This night, I will present you two wines. One from the Maule region. It is a Sauvignon Blanc from Viña Las Pitras. And then a blend, an ensemblage of Merlot and Syrah for the Colchagua Valley. Okay, in Chile you can find wine for the mountain, you can find a wine for the valleys, and also for the coastal area. This wine has different characters everywhere, everyone. You can find the freshness for the coast, you can find the strongness for the valleys, because it's the warming area that we have, and then you can find this fruity, for example, kind of wine for the mountain. Sorry, I'm nervous. You are a lot of people. Well, we're gonna do a wine testing, but Patrick, what do you think that is a wine testing? What is the sense to make a wine testing?
Why make a wine tasting?
Well, yeah, why make a wine tasting?
To appreciate the wine.
To appreciate the wine, yes.
So that you understand the complexity.
Exactly, that is the word that I like to say. To understand the wine, to know the wine, what the wine makes you feel. That is the sense for the wine tasting. But how to make a wine tasting? You have to follow some rules or some steps, okay? Alan? When you go to a supermarket, how you choose a wine?
Well, I think you begin with looking at the age of the wine, the type of wine, the type of meal that you want to have.
It's important, the age?
The age can be important. Yes, absolutely.
Sometimes it's important.
Sometimes
yeah.
It's important. Maybe for the white, maybe not so much, but uh-huh. for the red, yes.
But if you are a consumer that doesn't know anything about wine, you're not going to look the age.
No. So I think you're looking for the type of body mm-hmm. the wine would have, the type of the dryness or sweet.
Just look in the bottle, you can discover that?
Oh,
no.
Not so much. Not so much.
Okay. Well, my recommendation when you go to a store to buy a wine, just think and what you will eat with the wine. So if you will eat something soft, white meat, salad or pasta, for example, choose the white. And if you want to eat something strong, a barbecue or red meat, choose the red wine. Mm-hmm. That could be a simple
guideline.
Fine, you know the word.
Yeah.
That is a simple recommendation that I can give you. Think in what you will eat with the wine. Okay? So the first step is to choose the wine in a store, in your house, in the supermarket. And then going deeper with the testing. Okay, let me explain. You have three glasses. The first will be for the white wine, then the red wine, and the other glass is for your water. Please don't take the wine until I told you. Please, and you. So follow the step in the testing. You need to uncle just a little your glass over the white napkin. Yes. And just to look the color, to discover the color, the opacity, and the viscosity for the wine. The second step, swirl a little bit your glass. If it's difficult for you, you can do it over your table, like this. And smell it, to discover the aromas that this wine has. And then, okay, smell the wine, and then the important step for me is trying the wine. Put the wine in your mouth. And this is the most important step because it defines if the wine is good or not, or if the wine likes you or not. Okay, let's start with the testing. Please, everybody, take your glass and look at the color, and we can see here over your napkin, and we can see a pale yellow color. Yes, and it's shiny and it's clean. We don't need to spend more than 10 seconds looking our glass. Okay, it's not the important thing of the wine. Then the second step, swirl the glass to let all the aromas go out and smell it. And here we're gonna feel all the fruitiness that the wine has, all these aromas for, let me see, some lemon, some berry, I forgot the word, chili. Fruta madura. Yes, ripe fruit, ripe sweet fruit. We can feel it in our nose. And then the third step, please try the wine, put it on your mouth, leave the wine for a moment in your mouth, and then drink it. And here we have a wine with an acidity and in a medium level. The alcohol is not so strong, and you can still feel in the fruit. And you can still feel the intensity of the Sauvignon Blanc, and then the go keep stay for a while in your mouth and go. When that happened with a wine, I said that the wine invite you to take another glass. Why not? Yeah. What you think about the wine? Clearly, you said you don't like wine. Did you try? Try it. And tell me, what you feel with wine?
It's okay.
It's okay? It's the best answer. It's the best thing that you can say. Thank you. How you feel about the wine?
Okay, a comment from my side. I think it's good because it has this fruit taste.
Uh-huh.
And I like this compared with white wine. So this one I will enjoy.
Good.
Absolutely.
Good. Alan, you have some comment?
No, that's exactly my thoughts. Perfect. Nice fruity flavor. I enjoy it. Yeah.
Good.
Very, very light.
Patrick, I think you knew the wine.
Yeah, hang on.
Just to be sure.
Yes, I like this wine. No, it's
I like the sweetness and the grapefruit and the almost a sort of a nice apple in there as well. It's very nice.
Well, normally the Sauvignon Blanc has a high acidity because the grape we're planting on the coast, so receive all the freshness for this area. But this Sauvignon Blanc was planting in a central valley near to the coast, so it has the warm climate and also has the freshness for the cold. That is why we can feel the fruitiness, but we also feel our fresh wine. Let's try the second one with the same steps. Look at the color, and here we have yes, if you want to take a little bit of water between each wine, please.
Like a kid out of school.
I will do it.
What a fool. Now I see this is the end. I let her turn me down. Say, can we be friends? Oh, why should I care? Though she gave for me the air. Why should I cry, have a sigh, and wonder why? Yes, I should have seen.
Okay, so if we look at the wine, we can see a color close to the violet. It's not completely red, it's more dark. Yes? Then smell the wine. In here we have black fruit, hints of black fruit. We can feel some good also because this wine has a step, a time resting in a good barrel, French oak barrel. And this is a blend, so we can feel the characteristic for the Merlot and also for the Syrah. Two varieties pretty important in Chile. Then try please the wine. We're still feeling the ripe fruit. The, I don't know, what do you feel, Patrick? Help me, please.
I get the sort of blackberry, the fruitiness of of a blackberry or a black currant coming through from this one. Mm-hmm. I like it, it's a nice, heavy red.
So. Yes, it's not so heavy. This one, those are the characteristics of the wine. You can feel also this hints of meat, the Serrano ham, for example, I feel it. When I drink a Syrah, I always want to eat some Serrano jam with the Syrah. I feel that this wine has that. And also the black fruit, as you tell, and the ripened fruit. But the most important thing of this wine is that this wine were made for the student of University of Talca. And I wanted to recognize the work that they do because they make all this testing for you. They make all this organization for you. And I want to give an applause for the student. That we will serve you the wine, make this wine with their own hands. They pick up the grape, they harvest it, and then they made it at the university. So the teacher, Mónica Vergara, the professor Mónica, and then, well, Karen, Benmar, Victor, Dagoberto, Maria Ignacia, Fabian, Martin, can you please? Okay, this great team made this wine, and that is, for me, the most important thing that we have here. We are Rare Food, Monica, and for all the work that you make here. Okay. And well, my recommendation will still have, please enjoy every wine that you have. For me, there is no the best wine in the world. The best wine is always the one you choose. So thank you for being here. And keep enjoying the wine.